Looks like a win, but can't take a night off in this league.
And a little glimpse, a little feel, a basketball fever. These fans are feeling it in anticipation of this big game. Hi, everyone. Time to get into it. NBA action on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony, Hall of Famer Doris Burke, and another Hall of Famer, David Aldridge, from the sidelines. Now let's take a look at some of the numbers for him.
And guys, how about the surge of offense he's experiencing right now? These last five games, he's been a machine at the offensive end. A different score than he had been earlier in the season. We'll find out if he can keep it going here tonight.
Let's check out Chicago's starting lineup. Vucevic in at center with Williams next to him. Dosunmu is out there with Insanity. And it's LaVine at the small forward position. And for Boston, the small and power forwards, the star pair of Brown and Tatum. Holiday out there with Lonnie Walker. And it's Porzingis in at center. We've got ourselves an interesting matchup, Greg, in this one. One team more defensively focused, and the other side, an offensive team.
And Kevin, it should make for a compelling back and forth, right? A chance for both squads to test themselves and see which can impose their will on the other.
Now, here's Tatum. Brown sets a screen for Tatum, stolen by LaVine. Shoots over Brown, and some very quick points for him on that possession.
Yeah, LaVine, not a guy you want to concede that mid-range game to. So skilled in that area.
Outside, Walker. Down low. Here's Tatum. They grab their own miss. Here's Insanity. He's covered by Brown. And here is Dosunmu. Pass to Vucevic. Just five on the clock. Unloads from 13. That misses off the backboard. And so Holiday will bring it up for Boston. Victory eluded them last time in Chicago when they faced the Bulls.
Well, if they want to avoid the outcome of that first meeting, they'll need to be stronger on the glass. They were completely outmatched in the last one.
Well, you have to believe the coaching staff made that a point of emphasis. Better aggressiveness, better intensity on the backboards. Well, certainly not the best defensive effort, but this guy can't make them pay for their laziness.
in the first, a little over a minute and a half in. It's tipped and taken away by Brown. Levine against Walker. Pass to Tatum. Now Porzingis. Got a piece of it. And that's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession. We're just about 2 minutes into the first quarter. Down to five on the shot clock. Chalk up two there. And that makes it a tie ball game.
Wow, they finally get it to go down on their fourth try.
And you watch Jason Tatum. Year to year, he is a model of consistency. Across the board, the numbers are pretty similar. And the effort never wanes.
Now, here's Vucevic, who's averaging around 5.5 points a game. Here's insanity. And the Bulls with another miss. The Celtics have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Outside Tatum. Tries from 10. Porzingis kicks to Walker. And trying for the go-ahead basket. It doesn't go in. Levine against Brown. Outside Williams. The elbow, Vucevic. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. It's on Porzingis. The Bulls shooting their first free throws of the night right here. One falls for. That one is no good. GA, these Boston Celtics are unquestionably a top-tier offensive unit.
Stupendous shooting, excellent instincts with the ball. Yeah, they are a model offense in many ways, making it tough for many teams to keep up with them.
Well, you love the physicality by Porzingis. Mix it up off the backboards, KP.
And the timeout called here by Billy Donovan. This will give him a chance to discuss some potential alterations. Season, things becoming a little more clear in the power rankings. You look at the Bulls. They're gaining on some of the teams above them, trying hard to crack into that top five.
And checking out Chicago, they are well beyond where we thought they'd be at this point in the season, making incredible strides and maintaining their momentum.
Now, here's Dosunmu. No scoring in this one. And yes, it's good.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
But I think defensively, that is not the way you want to start. Giving up high percentage looks, that doesn't typically end well.
And the Celtics with possession here. After the Bulls pick up two. Brown wide open, he fires. Off target with his three.
And they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
Insanity, the pass to Levine. 3-on-3. Tatum on the wing. Porzingis with a screen on Williams. Tatum, that's for two. Misses off the left iron.
all alone from mid-range. They know he won't miss many of those.
A moment now to hear from our sideline reporter, Hall of Famer David Alder. David.
Hi, Kevin. Well, insanity in their last outing against the Nuggets got the job done. Dropped in 36 points and was aggressive on the glass with 9 rebounds. Numbers like that are sure to get attention from around the league. And everyone's excited to see what he does tonight. Guys?
Thanks, David. Yeah, it was a special night for him. The team really fed off his energy.
Yeah, the catalyst for that win, it was an effort that I'm sure he's hoping to replicate tonight.
Well, there's no doubt. He certainly looked like he was enjoying himself in that last game. He had his offense flowing.
Here's insanity. Jason Tatum picking up that last basket. We're only around halfway through this very long season, GM. This is when the grind, I think, really kicks in.
Yeah, you think about the physical and mental toll this game takes on you. And I miss being out there, but, man, I tell you, it can be a grind.
And he knocks down the first one. The Celtics making a switch here. Horford's checked in. The Bulls also changing it up. Smith checked in for Vucevic. Horton Tucker comes in for Zach LaVine. And Ball subbed in for Dostuma. And Williams drops them both. And here's Holiday, who will bring it up for the Celtics. It's a three-point game. Now, here's Brown, defended by Horton Tucker. Ball against Holland. Here's Insanity. And he's good on the three ball. Insanity's got 5 points.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
Brown deciding where to go with it. Get the shot. It's a very good look and converts.
And Brown can score from anywhere, which is what makes him a big problem for the defense.
Outside Williams. To the middle. Here's Insanity. Good. A nice assist for Williams. And it's 7 points for Insanity.
Boy, it seems like every shot he puts up, it's going in. This guy is hot. Hot.
Well, there's some recent news, and now on the phone we go to Shams Charania. Hey, Shams, what's going on?
Thanks a lot, Kevin. Time is of the essence leading up to the NBA trade deadline, but Miami's front office has been busy. They're bringing in Miles Bridges to shore up the front court of this team. Bridges is a minutes-eating, rebound-grabbing, explosive finisher, and I'm told this club knows that a player like Bridges brings competitive edge in close games. That boosts your chances to win in crunch time.
Hey, Shams, we appreciate the report. Always some interesting news to find out about the NBA. Bulls leading by 8. And when Porzingis goes to work inside, Doris, there are not a lot of answers for his son.
We know, Kevin, obviously, that post-ups become less and less a part of the game, but still an important one opportunistically. And you talk about efficiency in the post, that is Kristaps Porzingis. But not only that, the mid-range game is there, the three-point game is there, and the defense is there.
Holiday following the miss by Lonzo Ball from deep. Porzingis with a screen on Williams. Horford no luck. Well, Chicago's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game. Porzingis with the block.
Porzingis 7-3 says not here and not now.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Brown kicks to Walker. Steps back and fires. That one falls.
And the D just a step slow, reacting to the step back.
And so it's Chicago with a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter. Their defense has been terrific in this game. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. and thanks again for tuning in. Smith, he's checked in for Vucevic. Bouzelis comes in for Torrey Craig. Carter, he's checked in for Dosunmu. And it's Insanity in for Ball. Taking a look at the Bulls. They've got Levine. Bouzelis out there with Smith. Then there's Carter. And it's Insanity in at the point. And Tatum pulls it down. Celtics trail by four. Outside, Porzingis. Left side, Walker. Over Bouzelis. It's hauled in by Insanity. Insanity's got four rebounds now tonight. Outside, Levine. From deep. Rebound, Boston. Porzingis has got his fourth rebound in this one.
Boy, a really tough quarter for this guy. Just struggling to make shots right now.
Oh, another huge night for Tatum. One of the top scorers in the NBA. Jason beat you in so many different ways.
Now here's Levine. He's got six. Smith sets the pick for Levine. Shot clock at six. Puts up a deep three. And it's Smith missing. And here's Boston. Stringing it together. They've got an 11-2 run goal. And Holiday. And Holiday throws it down.
This is what you call a point guard with hops. Even though he's a little bit older, Holiday showing he can still throw it down.
Now the latest from our reporter David Alden.
Hey Kevin, Celtics coach Joe Mazzulla has talked about the two J's, Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum. He says they've been lumped together because they play a similar position, but they don't have to be similar. They've got to be able to express who they are and not constantly be compared to each other. They're not the same. Kevin?
Back, David, remember a couple of years ago, there was some thought that maybe one would be traded. I'm glad they're still together.
Well, this is the kind of shot we've come to expect him to make. He's got to be upset with that one.
Here's Insanity. 11 points in the game. Bouzelis with the ball. Pass to Insanity. On the wing. Rebounded by the Celtics. Tatum's got four rebounds now tonight. And Holiday has it in the corner. The kick out to Tatum. Takes the three. Rebound collected by Levine. And here's Levine who brings it up for Chicago. Their last win put them into double digits with 10 in a row. Wow. What a stretch.
Well, this is a basketball team that's really humming right now. And what you love is they're working together as a unit, which makes it fun to watch. What I'm curious about here is when teams start to adapt and take away their best strategy, how do they keep the streak going? Really, really interested to see how this plays out.
And we've got a timeout from Joe Mazzulla. He wants to regroup and go over the strategy. Now Horford checked in for the Celtics. Williams, he's checked in for Chicago. Horton Tucker comes in for Carter. On defense. They've led by as many as 11 points. Holiday looking for an opening. And here's Brown outside. Six on the shot clock. The Celtics need to get a shot off. Pulls up on the wing. Porzingis can't hit.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
Here's Horton Tucker. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Horton Tucker's got himself on the board with three there.
And guarding him on the perimeter isn't a priority for them right now, but if this continues, it will be.
To end the drought. Count that one. The Bulls' lead has been cut to just five on the basket from Brown.
Well, this is where having a tighter handle helps Jaylen Brown in pick and roll play. Just gets to his spot and scores it.
Insanity can't get it to go. Up top, Walker. Defended by Horton Tucker. Here's Holiday. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
First personal foul.
Celtics have been successful on three of their four free throw attempts up to this point. The first one falls. The Bulls making a switch here. Both free throws good from Holiday. For the first half, a competitive game so far. It's Chicago up three. And we'll be back with you right after this.
Welcome, everyone, to Halftime. The Chicago Bulls find themselves in a good matchup here at the break.
When you look at how they're getting their points, a good portion come from inside. They're going right at the defense.
I like the aggressiveness. Don't lose steam in the second half.
And now that we have some time, let's see how the All-Star voting is shaping up.
You can almost taste All-Star Weekend, the celebrations on and off the court. Shaq, you know all about that. Let me hear some memories.
It's like Vegas. What you do there stays there.
And that about wraps it up. And as the third quarter is about to begin, we go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
Half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. You know, guys, Jason Tatum has really been making it happen.
And how about the amount he's contributing in the scoring column? Through two quarters, he has been terrific.
And one would expect that the defense made some adjustments at halftime, but he has the ability to answer right back.
The Bulls leading by three. The post pair. Tatum and Porzingis. Walker out there with Holiday. And it's Brown in at the small forward. And that's the group for Joe Mazzulla as we begin the second half. Back to Tatum. Celtics passing it around. And it's in there. Holiday's got his third bucket of the night.
Oh, a nifty finisher. You didn't think Holiday would back down inside, did you?
It's safe to say Jason Tatum is a bona fide superstar.
He certainly is, Kevin, and really been a big-time star from the time he was 23 years old. Lots of pressure on this young player, but Jason's not only embraced it, he's thrived under it.
Now here's Tatum, following the miss by Porzingis.
This guy's been a catalyst for them all game long. What a job leading them to this lead.
The Bulls' shooting has been wayward so far. Only 37% from the floor. Here's Insanity. He's got 13. Pass to Williams. Outside, Levine. Now, here's Dosunmu. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
Big hops from the backcourt.
Oh, absolutely. And maybe just what they need to get this game, GA, going in their direction.
Boy, as tight as this one is, that's a statement play saying, hey, listen, we're not here to back down from you guys.
Here's Tatum. After the Bulls picking up a basket just moments ago.
it down, JT!
Well, Jason Tatum has worked hard to fill out his frame. It's not going to bother him that you're bringing a level of physicality.
Outside Williams. Vucevic, a screen on Tatum. Williams passes to Dosun. The three, Levine. And Boston with the rebound.
All right, time now to pick it up. You're 1-for-4, and you certainly don't want to give your opponent momentum.
It's stolen by Vucevic. Fast break, here comes Chicago. Here's Insanity, and he gets it to go. Insanity's got it all tied up now for the Bulls. The Celtics have gone 3-of-3 from the field since halftime. Williams against Tatum. And another basket for Boston.
Great play calling, great execution leads to 4-for-4 to start this half.
And Billy Donovan decides to call timeout. Wants to talk some things over, might be seeing some things to adjust.
Chance here. Let's now take a look at some point guards who have been dead on target from the floor over the course of the past 10 games. Well, you take a look at Insanity, leading the league in field goal percentage. He always gets good looks.
And he's been even more accurate with his shooting than he's been with his passing. Just a terrific percentage from the field.
And you have to keep in mind, a lot of those shots are coming from the perimeter. To have that kind of field goal percentage from the point guard spot is pretty amazing.
Analytics or the eye test? The optics or the numbers in front, Greg? When you're judging the performance of a player, what kind of criteria do you use?
Well, an MVP candidate recently said, my eye test tells me this guy's a terrible defender. But the analytics tell me he's a great defender. I'm confused. And I often feel the same way.
Here's Insanity. 19 points in the game. Over in the corner, Dosunmu. And it's Jason Tatum with the foul. That's his third foul of the game. Abuz Ellis has checked in for Chicago.
Bulls substitution. Number 14, Matisse Huzelis.
Here's Abuz Ellis. Here's Insanity. Pass to Craig for the lead. The shot's good on the assist by Vucevic. Craig's got 6 points.
This is where the size of Vucevic allows him to see over the defense. This guy, a terrific distributor.
Holiday, he's got 11. Walker with a clean look. And they come right back with their own three-pointer.
Wow, 5 straight buckets coming out of half. They are rolling.
Here's Insanity. Here's Vucevic. Rebound by Jrue Holiday. Holiday's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Inside. Tatum gets to Holiday. Here's the drive. And Holiday throws it down.
Well, Jrue Holiday just so strong with the basketball. Very hard to knock this guy off his course.
And here is Dosunmu. Pass to Insanity. 6 to shoot. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Clearly a foul.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Celtics.
They're doing damage from the mid-range. Not sure if that was the game plan or if they're just taking what the defense gives them. But thus far, it's paying off.
I think the other thing we're seeing tonight is the floor spacing of this team. Boy, they are shooting the cover off the basketball all game.
That's good from Insanity. Al Horford has checked in for Lonnie Walker. Chicago also making some changes. Jalen Smith, he's checked in for Vucevic. Horton Tucker comes in for Bouzelas. And it's Lonzo Ball in for Dostumer. That one misses, so he goes 1 for 2. Boston's gone 2 of 2 from long range in the third quarter so far. And Holiday kicks to Tatum. Here's Brown. Rebound by Smith. And here's Ball. He'll bring it up for the Chicago Bulls. Next game for him, they'll take on the Raptors at Toronto. That matchup falls in the middle game of this 3-game trip. To the inside. Here's Insanity. It's good. The assist that time from Ball. Ball's got 3 assists now in this one. For Boston, they've gotten 6 of their 7 shots to go down in this quarter. What a fantastic start to the half. Craig against Horford. Here's Tatum. Again, the Celtics good for 2.
Boy, that jumper is as pure as it gets. Jason Tatum off a pass from his teammate makes easy work of it.
And the timeout called here by Billy Donovan. And coach has decided they need a moment to talk things over. Standings now that we're in the new year. You look at Chicago, they're sitting pretty, second place, and looking to take the top spot. And of course, the Boston Celtics just way behind.
And you know, for the Bulls, they had a
checked in for Jaylen Brown, and it's Rose in for Drew Holiday. And let's head over to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, able to listen in on what Joe Mazzulla was going over with his team. He said to his guys, we need to push the pace more. Come on, guys, we're at our best when we're attacking in transition. Energy up now. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David. Dosumu up top. Pass to Insanity. It's hauled in by Cornette. Celtics trail by 6. So for Chicago right now, Levine and Williams up in the forward position. Insanity is out there with Dosumu. And it's Vucevic in at the pivot spot, manning the middle.
Now this is one of the best scorers in the game today. Jason Tatum, we're getting used to performances like this.
Insanity, the pass to Dosumu. Fires from deep. Boston grabs the miss. Tatum's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Pass to Rose. This one for 3. Good, and it's Tatum picking up the assist. Tatum's got his 4th assist in this one.
And as he's tried to preserve his body to play a complete season, Rose has begun to lean more on that outside jumper.
Driving the lane. Here's Dosumu, and he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for 2. In a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for the Bulls.
Guys, the D hasn't had an answer for the 3-point shooting, which is why they continue to just fire away from deep.
I think one of the things that also strikes me is their activity, forcing turnovers, coming up with steals. It has really shaped the tenor of this game.
The free throw drops for Dosumu. Boston making a switch here. Holiday's checked in. So he gets them both. Celtics trail by three. Here's Rose. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
And Derrick Rose, over 80% from the free throw line over his career. He makes you pay for those fouls.
Free throw drops for Rose.
Well, an interesting thing about Derrick Rose, right? Over his career, he's been an up and down jump shooter, but he's been remarkably consistent from the free throw line.
Rose hits them both.
Just solid. Really, one of the very best there is at the free throw line.
The Bulls have gone 1-4 since the end of the third quarter. Vucevic's screen on Rose. Here's Insanity. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Insanity's got 11 in the second half.
And how about the grit and determination in the post? I mean, essential qualities to have late in a close game.
Outside Holiday. Here's Tatum. Shot no good, a bit short.
Well, they'll be happy with that look, even though it didn't fall.
I think expect them to go back to it, because that's the kind of shot this offense is designed to generate.
Williams passes to Dosunmu. Fires the three, hands it from downtown. And the Bulls lead by six.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
You know, we see this all the time. You're basically, as a defender, hoping the man misses rather than putting in the work to get over screen.
And that one is good.
And just incredible focus from the veteran guard, Jrue Holiday, no stranger to scoring against a big-time contest.
And Billy Donovan decides to call timeout. Wants to make sure everybody's coordinated and intent. Celtics making a switch here. Hauser's checked in. Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Levine kicks to Williams. Outside, Levine. Vucevic's screen on Tatum. And there's the bucket from Dosunmu.
Just reliable, guys. He's just always trying to make the right play.
With the step back, here's Holiday. It's deflected. Pass to Williams. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Vucevic finds Dosunmu. Misses the three. Celtics trail by six. Tatum passes to Cornette. Count the basket and the foul. It's going to go on Dosunmu.
Well, known for being a terrific passer, he shows you right there. Case in point.
Jaylen Brown check in for the Celtics. Lonnie Walker comes in for Al Horford. And the free throw, no good. Chicago leading by four. Here's Insanity. It's hauled in by Cornette. Cornette's got four rebounds in this game. 11 feet away. Chicago grabs the miss. Williams has got four rebounds now tonight. Insanity, the pass to Dosunmu. three-pointer. Knocks down the three ball. Those Sooners got 10 points here in the second half.
Well, they're leading in large part because of the work he's put in this quarter. This is nicely done.
To the middle. Here's Holiday. Rebounded by Vucevic. Chicago has gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc since the final quarter's gotten underway. Here's Insanity. And no good. Trying to use the glass. It's Walker with the ball, bringing it up for the Celtics. And here's Brown outside. Rebounded by Vucevic. Vucevic has got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. And Insanity gets it to go.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
No, I think that's the one thing every player is searching for. Consistency. They're giving this guy a chance to carry the offense once again.
Boston again missing. The Bulls leading by 9. LaVine finds Dosunmu. Over Walker. And it's Chicago scoring again.
And with the lead, I like the strategy here. Continue to get the ball to guys who can do something with it.
One thing we've learned in the NBA, the game is never over. So you've got to continue to score, continue to build your lead.
And we've got a timeout from Joe Mazzulla. It's a chance for them to regroup and refocus. This is checked in for the Celtics. Entertainment. 1:57 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Here's Tatum. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Well, you like the level of aggression right there from Jason Tatum. Committed to scoring on the interior and draws the contact.
It's the first one, and that brings them to within 10.
Jason Tatum continues to emerge, guys, as one of the most elite players on both ends. We know on the offensive end he's a dangerous three-level scorer. He's also capable of locking you up defensively.
Both shots good from the stripe. It loose and it goes out of bounds. That one's off Holiday.
A split second late, but almost came up with a steal there.
Absolutely appreciate the effort, though. He really went after it. So close.
1:49 left in the fourth. Here's Insanity, guarded by Holiday.
Love seeing a point guard who can explode to the rim like that.
Oh, great attitude and even a better finish.
Boy, it's incredible how much explosive scoring ability can come from the lead guard position. That is a big-time play.
Hits the three-point bomb. Tatum's got 13 points in the second half.
What a weapon the three has become for Jason Tatum. Look out.
Here's Insanity. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. It goes on Jason Tatum.
Really on the right plate defensively. If you can't block, force him to the line.
Drops the first one, and that will put them up by 9. And it cannot convert on the second. That misses. And here's Brown. He'll bring it up for the Celtics. Well-placed jumper from the free throw line.
How easy does that pull-up jumper look by Jaylen Brown? So tough.
The Bulls leading by 7. Here's Insanity. 103 left to play here in the fourth.
Celtics foul. Second personal foul. Philip team foul.
Good on the first, and that stretches their lead to 8. And so he drops them both. It's a 9-point ball game. Well, for the Celtics, this one not looking good. And here's Tatum for 3. That shot misses. Chicago has won 3 of 5 from beyond the arc since the final quarter's gotten underway. Taken away by Holiday. And Tatum out top the key. From deep, Walker. Chicago grabs the miss. We've got 28 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Not sure the miracle keg is on hand here tonight for them.
Well, they need one, but gonna play it until the final whistle.
Pass to Insanity. A solid win on the road for them. This building was dead silent by the time GA this one wound down.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out of it by crunch time. Don't give them any chance to lift their team up at the finish.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Olden, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew. Thanking you for tuning in. We'll see you next time.
Way to bring the effort tonight. Good job, MP. I see you.